Hi everyone. Have you heard about or seen a house which produces a lot of things for its inmates? Start with fresh food, drinking water, electricity, cooking gas, and even car fuel. Sounds too good to be true. Friends, I visited this greenhouse. It's a 35-year-old house in Thiruvananthapuram named Manjali. And its proud owner is Mr. Thomas Mathew. He is an aviation man who lives by the philosophy, which in his own words is,
everybody be with the nature, nature will take care of you.
And he proudly claims that,
they now have no waste to waste.
Absolutely.
No waste to waste.
Does it sound interesting to you? If it does, I promise you, you are going to enjoy watching this video. So let's start the house tour now. Friends, Manjali is green in almost every possible sense of the word. This house transforms into a greenhouse due to a list of setups. So I've divided this video based on these setups. So feel free to jump to the setup or chapter of your interest and come back for the rest of the video later. Deal? The house tour started on a sweet note as we were served kumbilappam. It's a Malayali dish which is made up of rice flour, jaggery and the special ingredient jackfruit, and it's wrapped in tejpatta. And talking of food, we headed to the kitchen.
Just see this. This is the kitchen sink.
Mm-hmm.
And the peelings,
mm-hmm.
everything is
mm-hmm.
collected here.
Okay.
Bartan sab saaf karte hain.
Mm-hmm.
So whatever waste in there, even the plates and you know, after food, eating,
uh-huh.
all those goes in here.
Okay.
And just open the water, it goes through.
It goes through to?
Directly to the plant.
Food waste directly piped into the biogas plant. And many more such pipe connections shown later in this video.
So the major waste, which is bigger, we put it in, collect it in a bucket, and then we take it down. You know, that's normal stuff where it is connected from the hose, from the plant. So the plant is outside.
Basically, what you're saying is that all your gas requirement is met by the biogas?
Not fully. Okay. Certain days it may not be enough.
Okay.
But at an average, every day for cooking for 1 hour, gas is available.
Okay.
Previously, when this was not there, earlier we had to have a cylinder for a month.
Yes.
Now we need the cylinder only for 3 months. Okay.
So that's a lot of saving.
It is.
That's a lot of saving, and this is a free fuel.
Free fuel.
Once you have the installation.
So
we now step out to see the biogas plant, which he calls the domesticated biogas plant, which is not only connected to the kitchen sink as we just saw, but to this external feed setup and also to
the
toilets,
which is connected.
Okay, your WC is also connected. Correct. So basically, two in one.
It's a sewage being taken care, waste is taken care, gas is taken care. I have no septic tank.
No septic tank required.
I had the septic tank earlier.
Yes.
But then after 25 years, usually it will get and municipality has to pump it out.
Okay.
And that's again expensive.
Correct.
I then thought of why shouldn't I do this?
So how old is the biogas?
It's 14 years.
14, 15 years, right. So this was already in place, and then you thought, why not use it double up with the sewage treatment as well? And what is your experience?
Fantastic.
Okay.
I used to say I have no waste to waste.
Absolutely.
No waste to waste.
That's another great thing to say.
Yeah. And so this is the, and this plant is also known as a domesticated biogas.
Okay.
because it's been WC has been connected. I mean, this plant is special. I mean, it's not the normal one. Okay. Normal one, they can have a concrete structure dug into the floor, and then you know, it is they call it as a gobergas. And the gobergas, they used to have the cow dung. So people used to initially ask me, where is the cow dung?
Correct.
I said, we used our own dung.
Yes, absolutely.
That's why. So now this is a water jacket. This is hung in water, and the gas is produced. This will go up to the maximum level, mm-hmm. and when the gas is that maximum, mm-hmm. the gas will bubble up from the water jacket. Okay. So that gas will be waste.
Yeah.
So instead we cook normally,
yes.
and then when it is the gas is used, mm-hmm. this jacket, I mean this tank will go down, mm-hmm. because it is suspended in the water. Okay, so that is the system,
yes.
and periodically we have to turn it around. Turn this way,
yes.
turning it around makes a shoveling effect,
uh-huh.
for the waste inside.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, around.
Correct.
So there is a shaft-like thing inside the axis.
Yes.
So when you turn,
yes.
that thing is being shoveling happens.
Correct.
Okay, so that you know crust is not formed. The fermentation increases.
Yes.
More gas is produced.
Yes.
So every day we do this. Okay, once I had a problem with this,
yes.
because I never knew this. I had to call up biogas technicians. They came out, they opened up, they removed the crust,
right.
and then put a little more cow dung feed.
Yes.
Then restarted, and then they told me this has to be done.
So one question here is there a smell
yes.
generation?
Come. Yes. For this power, there's no smell.
Okay.
Okay. No foul smell, I mean.
Yeah, foul smell.
Okay. Now, for every volume of water or liquid goes into the system,
mm-hmm.
will come out from here. This is the outlet.
Okay.
And that outlet is called slurry.
Slurry.
Yeah.
Okay.
And the slurry is collected here by me.
Okay.
In a small tank,
okay.
which is normally not with this. Mm-hmm. It's connected with a motor up there.
The slurry
is pumped up.
Oh, the slurry is pumped up.
To my roof.
Okay.
In a separate tank.
Okay.
And that slurry is used for my irrigation, for all the plants.
Okay, and it's a fertilizer.
It's a fertilizer.
So as we see, the pipeline connections are designed in a way that the nature is put to good use. There is a lot to be told about the higher floors of the house, but now I would like to draw your attention to another important feature of this house, and that is rainwater harvesting, and that too in a very low cost, common sense way.
People normally, when water is flowing from outside, they normally keep a hump,
yes,
so
yes.
that it doesn't come in.
Correct.
I don't keep a hump.
There is no hump.
There's no hump here.
Yes.
It flows in. It flows in and comes to this channel.
Yeah, this is something which is useful for not letting it enter your home.
Yeah, so it is collected through this channel.
Yes.
Goes through.
Yes.
There's a pipe under and goes out there.
Yes.
And water seeps there.
Yes. Yeah. I saw.
One level of stairs there.
Yes, yeah.
And then another level of stairs here.
And then
so the water comes to the ground.
Water is collected all the
here.
Wastewater is collected here.
Yeah.
Yes.
Goes into that pit down there.
Pit here, which you have specially constructed.
There's a pit on the other corner.
Okay.
So from both sides.
Yes.
The earthen pipe is down there.
Okay. There is a piping system.
Piping system.
Which takes
come
to
that particular point.
Okay.
Where the pit has been done about 12 feet down.
Yes.
And in the pit.
Yes.
Small stones from the sand.
Okay.
Gravel is put.
Yes.
And on top of that, sand is put.
Yes.
So the water seeps down.
Yes.
It doesn't clog down there. It goes down.
Mm.
Further down. Yeah.
The gravel and...
Otherwise, you know, the clay-like sand, it wouldn't seep the water.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Yeah.
Due to that.
And the water finally...
And finally, it ends up in this. It's a full cycle.
Full cycle.
You know,
can you see the well?
Yeah, why not? Yeah, we can see the well.
Oh, it's pretty deep.
Pretty deep, yeah. And there is a rings. I have total 13 rings, and each ring is 2 feet, makes it around
maybe around 30 feet depth.
It's okay. So Neil is drinking well water here.
This is where this I drink normally like this, and I do have a water therapy every day. Early morning, the first thing, I have a minimum half a liter of water gulped down straight. And this water is from the well, boiled, cooled down, filtered, and this.
That's great. Super.
Okay.
Yes.
Good.
Now we are headed to the upper floor of the house to explore more collaboration with nature. Friends, we have already seen how the biogas plants. It takes care of the cooking gas requirement. It also provides organic fertilizer for the plants, and it doubles up as the sewage mechanism of the house. And then we saw how a simple mechanism of steps and channels have led to an effective rainwater harvesting and accumulation of almost every drop of water to nourish the plants and to replenish the drinking water well that is at the backyard. But this is not all. There is so much more, which includes terrace farming, solar energy, and electric vehicles. So join me in the next part of the video for all of this. That comes in the coming Friday. That is exactly 1 week from this video. Hope to see you there. Bye for now. Please like and subscribe and let me know which part of the house appealed to you the most or you found unique. Also, if you love the video, do share the love with your family and friends.
People feel it's a hard work to do what you have been doing. So what would you say?
Anybody can do this kind of thing. All what is required is just the will to do it.